Vaudeville, the heart of American show business, was the most popular form of entertainment from 1880 until the 1930s. Tony Pastor, a circus ringmaster turned theater manager empresario, hoping to capitalize on and attract families to this type of entertainment, barred the sale of liquor and bawdy material in his theaters. Pastor's experience proved successful, and other theater managers soon followed suit. Vaudeville was a successful form of entertainment. A variety show, including lowbrow or popular acts, like acrobats, animal acts, and comedians, shared the stage with opera vocalists and classical musicians, regarded as highbrow entertainment. By the late 1890s, vaudeville had large theaters erected all over the nation. If a performer were to land a chance to perform in one of these shows, they would travel the circuit of theaters, performing all over the country. After an evening of vaudeville, Alexander Pantages, who owned more than 30 vaudeville houses, was captivated by a small song and dance performance by a little tot, and within days signed her on. At the ripe old age of 8, Mama Burnside landed a job with the Pantages vaudeville circuit. Mama Burnside was born Ella Jane Poto. Her mother and father realized Ella Jane's talent at an early age, and soon added her to their already established act, the Poetical Potos, only to discover that Ella Jane was the one audiences wanted to see, and soon she was performing her solo act, billed as Baby Ella Jane. She performed a baby doll routine to the delight of her audiences. She continued to perform this routine well into her teens. At the Bijou Theater, she emerged as a young woman of gentility with her rendition of I Want to Be Happy.
I want to be happy, but I won't be happy till I make you happy too. Life's really worth living when you are worth giving. Why can't I give some to you? When skies are grey and you say you are blue, I'll send the sun smiling through. I want to be happy, but I won't be happy till I'm
while performing at the lavishly appointed Giddee Theater, she met veteran song and dance man Walter Sebastian Burnside. It wasn't long before romance filled the air, and Mama and Papa Burnside teamed up as a couples act and won the hearts of the American people. They traveled the Orpheum circuit for the next 6 years with their new routine, from vaudeville house to music hall, receiving ovations from both patrons and managers alike. The audiences loved them.
A holy clover that I overlooked before. First leap is sunshine, the second is rain, the third are the roses that bloom in the lane. There's no explaining, the one remaining is somebody I adore. I'm looking over a pretty little poorly
they were toasted as royalty in every little town across the country. They always commanded top billing. And were lauded as the performers of the century. Mama and Papa Burnside were requested back to the Giddee Theater by Sir Harry Wellington, where it all began for them, to take up residence and to perform the acclaimed Scary Harry Puppet Show with Harry Ketchum, also a renowned vaudeville comedian. But that is another story. We caught up with Mama and Papa Burnside backstage at the Giddee Theater.
I feel like I'm back where it all started. It's wonderful.
We plan to be here a long time. There are big plans in the works.
Mr. Harry Ketchum and Walter are working on a new musical for the Giddee, and maybe a moving picture show.
Moving pictures seem becoming more popular right now, but there will always be vaudeville. It's an exciting time here at the Giddee, isn't it, Mama?
Oh, yes.
And we'd like to thank Sir Harry Wellington for his support. We must be getting back to rehearsal now.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
And thank you, Mama and Papa Burnside. Much success to you now and in the future. And as Papa Burnside said, there will always be vaudeville. It's the heart of American show business. Vaudeville.